Hi there! Today I'm going to share how to make your best FreeVPN choice. Now ensure you watch until the end of this video because I'm going to share which FreeVPN you should equally avoid. Let's get into it. So, what is VPN? VPN is an acronym for Virtual Private Network. So, VPN is an encrypted connection over the internet from a device such as your phone, laptop to a network. So the question is, why should I use VPN? Alright? Now, the number one reason why you should use VPN is because it gives you online privacy by masking your IP address. Meaning, it stops unwanted individuals from observing what you do online. Another important reason why you use VPN is it prevents you from being tracked by your internet service providers who can track you using your IP. Remember, your IP uses, you know, your location, that's your city, your zip code, okay? Now, your internet service providers or your ISP can access your browsing history as long as you are using their network to browse the internet. And they can decide to sell such information to companies that are interested in them. Okay? However, if you're in a country that is a member of the European Union, then you don't have to worry. Why? Because the General Data Protection Regulation, called GDPR, expressly forbids your ISP from even collecting your data without your express permission. So that's one of the importance of using VPN. Now, one important point you should know is that a VPN will not make you completely anonymous. Why? Because websites use trackers and cookies to tailor their services to your specific needs. So they store details about you, such as your name, geographical location, and can be used to identify you despite using a VPN. Check how VPN works. Anytime you connect to the internet using your phone, your laptop, or any other device, what you do is you join a pool of people that are connected to a public network. And when you are on the internet, you should know that you are not protected. You are exposed. That is when you need a VPN. So VPN creates an encrypted tunnel where all your communication is protected online. Now that we saw some good aspects of FreeVPN, there are also bitter facts about VPN as well. So let's look at them. About 70% of all FreeVPN gather your online activity so they can sell it to advertising companies that need those data. A Cicero study has found that nearly 40% of FreeVPNs for Android have a malware. According to Malwarebytes Lab, 21 million FreeVPN users' data exposed as of 5th of March 2021. Now, so we're going to be looking at some FreeVPNs you should go for. The first one is Proton VPN, which I use also. We'll be looking at Atlas, and then we'll be looking at Windscribe VPN. Now, there are some major drawbacks to using free VPNs. If you want to use free VPN, it should be because you want to test to see which one you should go for at the end of the day. And then probably you don't have money to pay for the premium ones. That should be the reason why you should go for free VPNs. However, I strongly recommend that you go for the premium VPN where you get better services and then they are more secured. Now, the drawbacks to using free VPNs, you know, most of them, you know, increases data consumption. Generally, as you use VPN, you know, the VPN tries to encrypt your network, and so therefore it leads to increased data consumption. So free VPN are generally slow, okay, and then they have limited server options. So like one of them that we mentioned earlier, Proton VPN, it gives you access to just 3 locations, okay, and then most of them you can only use them on one device. Now, free VPNs also have limited bandwidth uses. Most of them limit your usage of bandwidth. Okay, another drawback is that most of them can't unblock streaming platform. Now, streaming platform are those platforms online that allow you to access them 24/7. All right, for example, you have platform like Netflix. So most of these free VPN does not allow you access to platform like Netflix. So that's one of the drawbacks. Now, when most of these free VPNs, as you use them, they clog your browser with so much apps. You know, as you're browsing, you know, you see so many apps, you know, appearing on your browser, you know, and then if you're not careful, when you click any of them, you get exposed and you begin to have privacy issues. Now, what is the difference between free and paid VPN? Now, basically, private paid VPN are more private and secure. They are more reliable. Now, free VPN, they can tell you that they are private, they are secure, but they are not as secure as the way they should be. So, the reason why you should even go for free VPN is because you want to test and see how they work before you make your decision. And then, probably if you don't have money to pay for the premium VPN, that's when you should go for free VPN. However, I strongly recommend that you choose paid VPN because they are secure, they are reliable, and they are fast. They don't limit your bandwidth usage, and you can gain access to different streaming platforms. Okay, so any day, anytime, I recommend that you go for paid VPN. Free VPNs comes with features that gives you good experience as you use them. Okay, so the first one we'll be looking at is Proton VPN. It's one of my favorite VPN as well. So it comes with features like no data caps. So you can browse, you can make use of the internet, you know, with unlimited bandwidth. So it has an IP version 6 leak protection, VPN kill switch, 256-bit AES encryption. So the paid version has different plans. One of them is called basic plans. That's the minimum one in terms of pricing. And it costs $3.29 per month. So it gives you access to streaming platform, torrenting, grants you access to blocked content online, and then 800 servers in 50 different countries. So this is the interface. This is how it looks like. So anytime you connect to Proton VPN, it gives you access to 3 different countries only that you can connect to. You can also see where the location you are connected to, the IP address, and other features that are there. So the second one we'll be looking at is WinSky VPN. Now, when it comes to security, you know, WinSky VPN is a pretty special VPN, you know, and it comes with features like stealth mode, ad blocker, VPN kill switch, and it has a way to turn your phone into a Wi-Fi hotspot. That's one of the important features in WinSky VPN. And then it has time zone spoofing. Now the paid version has different plans as well. However, if you want to use just one location, you know, then you can go for build a plan version. So this one gives you just $1 per month, you know, and you can have access to just one location. You have access to unblocked, you know, streaming content like Netflix. Okay, now it has other plans, you know, like one of the plans is $4.08 that gives you access to 500 servers in 10 different cities. You can have access to content like streaming platform, torrenting, and all of those. So this is the interface of WinScreen Free VPN. Now WinScreen VPN also gives you access to 10 different countries that you can connect to, and then it has data caps. So on a monthly basis, WinSky VPN gives you access to 2 gigabits of data if you do not register. However, when you sign up with them, you can have access to as much as 10 gigabits of data per month. you know, as we solve the internet. Now, the last one we'll be looking at is Atlas VPN. Now, Atlas VPN is a pretty special VPN. It's the best in terms of streaming and torrenting. Okay, so it comes with certain features like Netflix US and Netherlands, so you can have access to, you know, Netflix, you know, using free Atlas VPN. Now it has 256 bit encryption, VPN kill switch, P2P feature as well. Oh, I almost missed that. Now, WinScribe paid VPN comes with different, features as well. And then it gives you access to unblocked streaming content like Netflix, gives you access to torrenting. It gives you access to unlimited device. That means you can install it on your laptop, on your phone, on different device at the same time. It also gives you access to 750 servers in 27 countries, and then you can have access to 24/7 email support. So all paid VPN offer you support. All right, so for WinScribe VPN, it gives you access to $2.18 per month. So that's the cost of subscribing for paid Atlas VPN. Now that you know which free VPN is best to use, you also need to know which free VPN you ought to avoid at all cost. One of them is the HolaVPN. HolaVPN keeps logs of your information and browsing activity and sell it to data companies that need those information. When a user accesses certain domains with geo-blocking, the HolaVPN redirect the request through the connection of other users in non-blocked areas, thereby circumventing the blocking, you know, of those geo-blocking features. So this is one of the free VPN you ought to avoid. Secondly, we are looking at the Aki VPN. Aki lacks both essential and advanced security features. It is also run by ads. So Aki VPN was listed at number 6 on the top 10 most malware infected Android VPN app. Okay, now funded by ads, which is also a compromise on your privacy. Now we're also going to look at Turbo VPN. Now what this VPN is, one of the most installed, you know, VPN, especially for Android users. Now it collects data about you and your traffic, which is the easiest way to trace you and your location. It is funded by ads, which is a compromise on your privacy, because data about your browsing habits goes straight into the hands of advertisers. It has DNS leaks and it is unsafe as for free VPN. So these are the three we are looking at. However, there are other free VPN out there that you ought to avoid, but these are the only three VPN we just want to cover. Now, don't forget that the best VPN to use are the paid ones, okay? Because they don't make their money through adverts. Since you pay them for those services, they give you the premium features that you need, okay? So any day, anytime, I recommend that you go for premium VPN. Thank you for, you know, taking time to watch this video. Please remember to subscribe, like, comment on this video, and share.